The HOPE program was formed to provide care and support to individuals who presented to our service either post a suicide attempt or with suicidality. The HOPE program is quite a unique service within our mental health service, and through the multidisciplinary team of the HOPE program, we can provide support and care for up to 90 days or 12 weeks. The aim of the HOPE program is to build capacity and resilience to individuals and their loved ones, as well as work through what ultimately brought them into the HOPE program. And Michelle, it would be great to hear what your HOPE experience was.
Kate, the HOPE program offered me hope in a time when I needed it. And Anne was a great support to me, whether that be to sit and just be, or to go for a walk and a talk. She offered that safe harbour and comfort when in a time you're lost, and that made me become more resilient. I learnt to gain my strength back and my confidence, and it's just a great service. If it was there beforehand, I would have definitely accessed it.
So Michelle, as you know, we completed a really extensive co-design project in 2022 along with all the rest of the HOPE team, and it was a really collaborative process. And are you able to sort of give us a bit of an insight of how you found it?
Sure. It was very interesting for me because it connected me back into the service, and the co-design process is a great leveller. So there was lots of robust discussion on how we could provide the expansion of the HOPE team.
I suppose from our perspective, completing the co-design project and having that ability to, as you said, be that leveller, was able to build on the foundations of the HOPE expansion.
Yes.
And that's ultimately brought about, you know, more clinicians into the team, expanded hours, and really, I suppose, listening to our community about what they would like within the HOPE program. And it was a great opportunity through a really extensive process to be able to provide that.